Hey class, welcome to the laboratory section of geotechnical engineering for this spring semester. I'm here in our geotechnical engineering teaching lab. It's a really cool space. You're just gonna have to take my word for it. It probably doesn't look that cool on camera, but there's a lot of interesting stuff here that pertains to soil and the analysis of soil in terms of civil engineering. So it's just gonna be me in here this semester. I really wish you guys could join me, but hopefully throughout the semester we'll have some opportunities for some of you students who are on campus in Jacksonville to come in and work hands-on with some of this equipment and see how it pertains to the material that we're covering in the lecture portion of this class. So in this lab, we're going to be doing the moisture content of soil. It's a very basic test, but very important when it comes to defining the index properties of soil, which relates the physical qualitative properties to the mechanical design properties that we care about, and we'll talk a lot more later on in our lecture class. So for now, I'm just gonna go over the materials. We'll go over the procedure really quickly, and I'll show you guys the soil samples that we're taking the moisture contents of, give you all the values, and then you'll be able to produce your lab report from all that. Don't forget, let me know if you have any questions or if any of this isn't making sense. I'd love to clarify this in any way I can, and I just really wanna make sure you guys are all on the same page when it comes to this physical property of soil. Okay, so let's review the materials that we need for this lab. Just a few key things that are important for this one. One being our hand auger. This is gonna be the way that we retrieve soil samples at the ground surface, at 1 foot, at 2 foot, and at 3 feet deep. We have our tray. These are the soil samples that have already been collected. We'll show these in more detail. Surface. And of course, we need our moisture cans. So these are the cans that we're going to be placing our samples in before and after we put them in the oven. Speaking of which, we need to take the masses. So of course, we have our scale. And note the scale is sensitive to 0.01 gram. And then we also have our oven. Now the oven is where we will place the soil samples for 24 hours, and of course we'll assume that while they're in the oven, all the water is going to be evaporated out. So if we take the mass before we place it in the oven and after the oven, subtract those two, we can get the mass of the water that has left the soil. Okay, so first things first, we need to take the empty mass of our moisture cans. These are all empty, cleaned out, and they're all numbered as well. So moisture can number one is going to be the sample at the surface, and then two will be the sample at 1 foot, three will be the sample at 2 foot, and then four will be the sample at 3 feet. All right, let's take a closer look at the soil specimens we collected. So remember, we first took some at the ground surface. Now remember, part of this lab is to take qualitative observations. So you want to look at the color and the texture and make sure to write those down when you're describing the soil. Any other additions to the soil, such as rocks, pebbles, or other types of matter are also important to note. And I'll be providing a picture here that should show it in a little bit more detail. So this is our surface layer. Next, we took a sample at approximately 1 foot in depth. And again, here's a clearer picture. And here is our sample at 2 feet in depth. And then finally, 3 feet in depth, about a meter down, we took this soil sample. Okay, so I've emptied the contents into these little evaporation dishes just so you can get a clear picture. on the camera, but also so it's a little bit easier to move the sample into the moisture can. So here we have our sample from the surface, sample at 1 foot, 2 feet, and 3 feet, and we need to put now the natural soil in the moisture cans, in each respective moisture can. We've already taken the empty mass of these dry. So once we fill the soil in these cans, reweigh that, that will be our M natural. So remember, we don't need to measure the amount of soil we're putting M natural in to our moisture can because it's just a simple ratio. All we need to find is the dry soil versus the amount of water, the mass of water. So as long as we fill them about halfway up in the moisture can, we should have enough specimen that we can discern when the water is evaporated out and we can have a noticeable value when we put them in the oven versus when we take them out. Okay, next step would be to place our moisture cans with the natural soil in it. So this is the in situ, it's the wet sample. We need to place these in our oven. Our oven is set to 110 degrees Celsius. We're going to leave them in the oven for 24 hours. And again, we're assuming that after 24 hours, all the water inside the pore space of these samples will be evaporated. So if we take the mass of the sample before and after, we can subtract that out and get the mass of the water.